Go therefore and make disciples, and make them in the possession of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Four days ago, we celebrate the Feast of the Resurrection. And in those 40 days, Jesus not only met with his disciples, appeared to them, but also instructed them to remain in Jerusalem till the Holy Spirit comes. When he comes, being the power of God, the advocate, he will remind you, he will teach you what I have told you, and be with you to strengthen you in time that you need him, especially in time of persecution. In the first reading today, we saw the beginning from the Gospel. In the Gospel today, we saw how Jesus was taken up to heaven. He was taken up to heaven purposely, because now his mission is over. And the mission of Jesus was not only to die for us, but to establish a church. And through that church, we will be saved. That's why many sometimes, you know, get criticized, the Pope Francis, when he said that any Christian without church is nothing. You cannot survive without the church. Each one of us, when we are baptized, we need somebody to baptize us. We need somebody to give us communion. We need somebody to forgive our sins. And so we need the church. And that's why there is no identity of a Christian without the church. Because this was the mind of the founder. Now I am sending you. He didn't say I send individual. I am sending you to go and teach all nations. And what are you going to teach the nations? What I have told you. And those who come to repentance and they receive baptism, they will be part of the mystery of God, the Trinity. And that's why in the first reading today, we begin the Acts of the Apostles. It is chapter 1, verse 1 to 11. Why? Because now the apostles took very seriously that Jesus did not abandon them, but he is with them. And he is with them because now, on the day of Pentecost, which we are going to celebrate 9 days from tomorrow, he will strengthen them and give them the power to go out and make Jesus known. And that's why he said to us today, and when that Holy Spirit that was given to Jesus on the day of his baptism, you say, was given to him, well, the Holy Spirit testified to Jesus, this is my Son, on whom my favor rest. Listen to him. So there is not anymore the Torah, there is not anymore the law, there is not anymore the prophecy, because they are fulfilled in the person of Jesus. We have one person to listen to, and he is the voice of I don't teach you my own teaching. I hear it from the one who sent me. I don't do nothing of my own, but I do what the Father asked me to do. And that's why the apostles, as they saw Jesus ascending in front of them, they were looking at the sky. But look what the angel said to them. Men of Galilee, stop gazing at the sky. Go now and begin the job. Because the mandatum of Jesus of evangelization is very, very urgent. And that is what the church is missing today. We are not evangelizers. We are not making the message of Jesus. We have been given to us by virtue of baptism, because we also sometimes we gaze. Sometimes we say, what can I do? There is lots of things you can do. Number one, make sure you have a good relationship with the Lord. And that relationship we call it encounter with Jesus. That you have a relation with him like a friend to friend, like talk to him heart to heart. And when that relation is really founded, then you are going to find yourself moved, prompt to go and make him known. Because no one loves somebody and hide him in a closet, but make him known. Introduce him to other people whom he needs, when he is with or with that friend. And the same thing with us. We are not here to sit in the pew on a holy day like this, but we are here to evangelize, to make the church known. And how are you going to make it known? Number one, as I told you, you have to have that relationship. Number two, a very important part of integrity is a good life that corresponds to the gospel. We cannot contradict the gospel by the way what it is. Otherwise, nobody is going to listen to you. Nobody is going to look up to you. Because you are like the bell that tonight rang on the top of the tower here. But you don't see the bell in the view. Stay there. St. Paul said, who is love if it's not moved by that love of God within us? It's like a gun that's poured but that has no action. The love of Christ moves us. And that's why that second reading of St. Paul said that the love of God is within us. What great call we have. What nobility we are, that we were as part of the plan of salvation. That God sent his Son to die on the cross, to rise from the cross, and now he is seated at the right hand of the Father, not to abandon us, but to watch and wait for us to arrive at our destination. And in the meantime, he gave us himself in the word and sacrament with the power of the Holy Spirit to strengthen us on this particular way towards it. That's the journey of each Christian, dear people. And in that road towards eternity, we are going to find a lot of up and downs. And that's why we need the Holy Spirit to strengthen us. We need the Holy Spirit to help us. As I told you last Sunday, if we live our confirmation, we have nothing to fear. We don't need meetings and people to tell us how to live, because our confirmation is when I confirm what my mother and father did at the fountain of baptism when I was not aware of what's going on. That means I renew the promise of baptism by denying what is sin and believe what is good and believing God. And that is really what the Ascension is all about. Ascension is that Jesus manifests himself to go to the Father, as we say in the opening prayer, our head, because Jesus is the head of the church, where our head has already gone, the body, which is the church, one day is going to be united with him. And this is what ascension is our hope. That this life that we are leading is a life that leads us to that great glory that Jesus has won by his death and by his resurrection. As we go to the celebration of the Mass tonight, let us really make it a very important point. Many of us say, well, you know, after all, we are so wounded. In a few weeks we are not going to be anymore. This congregation, we have to disperse and go someplace else. But why disperse? Why will it not continue to be a community? Because we are not evangelizers. We come to church and we talk about people. We come to church and we decide the priest how long it's going to be, because sometimes even looking at the watch reminds me of what you are thinking. Criticizing this one, criticizing that one, and who is coming. That kind of a church we are. And you think that you are going to grow? No, we cannot grow like that. The church is one. And the gift of the Holy Spirit that was given to many, to all of us in a different form, they have to come together like an orchestra. Many instruments coming together, and we don't play what we want, but we follow the conductor, so that harmony of the orchestra will follow the church. The church church is all of us come together to play a hymn of praise, to sing praises to God, and in the meantime, by our life, we attract others to come to know Jesus. If you have people at home that don't go to church, you say, what am I going to do about it? Well, God gave your children to sanctify them, to make them holy. If that child of yours is going to lose his soul, you are full responsible. Don't tell your father he's 75 years old. You brought that child, it was given to you as a gift, and God wants that child to be saved. And your job is not how much money you're going to leave them in the bank to fight over it, because no, you all will be sent behind your hearse to take it with you. But you are going to do the best you can. Number one, that you live a good life. That you do not speak one word, and then behind closed doors you speak another word. You have to be authentic. And your children will see the life that you live, and the happiness that you radiate, they want and they attract to that life. But how can they imitate you when you, from morning to night, on the phone, gossip about this one and that one? You cannot stand your neighbor, you cannot do this, you cannot even open your wallet to give an arm to somebody. You never reach out to community because you are so close in yourself. How can you attract others? Evangelization is not just going from here, go to India or go to Africa. We have a mission in America. In fact, the church, the Catholic Church in America, according to the canon of the church, is still missione terra, terra missione. That means it's still a mission, because it's not even evangelized. The 50 states are not even evangelized. There are people who are not really evangelized. And you know what does that mean? It means there are people in your own neighborhood, there are people at your work, there are people in the circle of your life, and they don't know Jesus. And they're not going to know Jesus because you're going to give them an eatlet, because they will put it in the trash. You know how they know Jesus? By you, be the light that really enlightens the darkness of their life. By blessing yourself when you eat. By saying a prayer when things go wrong. By remember somebody because of bad news did not report to work, and you join them together and say a prayer. That is the way we lead others. Not you are afraid even in a restaurant to bless yourself. Many times I go and I see Catholics that don't even bless themselves. According to my father, the pigs eat without prayers. Well, dear people, what are we going to take it in this head? That we are not going to go and knock on doors and say either you believe in Jesus or we'll kill you. This is not the way to do it. We are not anymore in those days of the time of the church, the darkness there of the church. But we need to really understand that each one of us, with little we do, all of us, that little we do, become big. St. Teresa of Calcutta, what did he used to say? I do little things for Jesus. Do you do things for Jesus? Or do you do it for yourself, your comfortability? Oh, I'm not going to mass today. After all, in the middle of the week, I work at 6 o'clock, and then, after all, I have to take care of myself. You take care of yourself, right? When you tomorrow go to work, and you, around 10 o'clock, you feel a little pain here, and before you know it, they rush to the hospital and say, listen, you have a massive heart attack. What are you going to do then? Our life is all in God's hands. And we need to do what we are able to do now. Because the day when we arrive at the destination, our days of doing is over. And then when you are going to appear in front of God, what kind of a plate are you going to have? repentant faith or a full faith? What kind of marriage you are going to present yourself to enter the kingdom? Because to go to heaven is not just born and die. It is that you accept an invitation to love Jesus, to know Jesus, to serve Jesus. So after this life, you will be with Jesus. And that's why St. Teresa of Avila used to say, Jesus does not have any body in this life, but you are his hands, his feet. You are his members of the body. And so all of you are needed, so the body will come. And dear people, the call of evangelization is very urgent. There are lots of people who need to know about good news. But unfortunately, there is no one to teach them. And I conclude with the words of St. Paul. How blessed are the feet of those who announce the good news. But how can they descend if they are not called? And why they are called? To bring the good news.